you, Patriots. Today is a fabulous Friday, October 1st. Happy Friday.
Today is the first day of October. Can you believe it? September is over. So is our focus on the learner profile communicator. That means we celebrate all of our Student of the Month communicators.
If you haven't done it already, take a moment to watch Mrs. Greco's Learner Profile of the Month video to celebrate all of our Students of the Month.
In October, we focus on the learner profile of principals. Stay tuned on Monday for a video about our new learner profile of the month. And be on the lookout for principal patriots in your class.
Those Dos Amigos are back. Here they are to wrap up our week with fun and probably a little chocolate syrup. Take it away, ladies.
Hey, 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 good morning. Woo-hoo!
Friday.
Hey, not only is it Friday, it's a new month. It's October.
October uno.
Oh, boy. But first, we got to have breakfast.
Absolutely. Most important meal of the day.
Oh, yummy.
That is good stuff.
Hey, 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 we got a lot going on next week. We're going to start with global reading next week.
Yeah, global read aloud all week next week. Yep. And get this, Science Palooza. That should be really
science.
Lots of fun. And you know what else is going to be real fun, too, is next Wednesday, it's early release day. Well, I should say fun for your students because you get to go. We teachers still have to stay and work, but that's okay.
We do work. We work, work, work.
Yes, we do.
Students aren't here.
Hey, speaking of working and hard workers, we have a hardworking staff member here that we're going to introduce right now, and it is Coach Herman.
Woo!
Coming on to the shot. Here's your sombrero because you're an amiga.
Yes.
Coach Herman rhymes with Coach Terman.
Hey.
So Coach Terman, Coach Herman.
And we are so happy that a lawnmower is coming while we're doing this interview. Well, we can raise our voices.
Yes, we
are PE people.
Yes.
So, Coach Herman, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, I am Coach Herman, and I am from Lando Lakes, live right down the street. I have three sons, two are at Lando Lakes High School, and one is at the University of Florida.
Woo, go Gators!
All right.
And do you have any pets?
I do. I have a fabulous poodle named Zelda, and she's a crazy dog. We had to enroll her in classes. She's done agility. She's done dock diving.
Dock diving!
Different kinds of training. And she only will eat. She has to work to eat her food, so she wants it in different types of puzzles just to keep herself busy.
Oh, wow. My goodness. Yeah. Tell me about dock diving. They run on the dock and they jump in the water?
That's exactly what they do. They first start to walk in slowly, but she did that during the beginner class, and that during the beginner class, she actually jumped off the dock, which is saved for a later class.
Oh,
wow.
So she's an advanced dock diver.
She is.
There you go.
And how far does she jump when she jumps far?
She jumps about 3 feet right now.
Okay.
Wow,
she's
nice.
Getting there. She's getting there. And I understand that you have somewhat of a poetry hobby.
I do. I like to write haikus. Just they reflect current moods and situations.
And can you tell me exactly what a haiku is?
A haiku is a Japanese poetic form, and it consists of three lines with five syllables on the top line, or five claps, seven syllables on the middle line, and five on the bottom. And you're supposed to get your point across and the most minimalist amount of words as possible.
Wow, and can you give us an example of a haiku?
Oh, let's see. We are here. Pine View Patriots, amazing IB students, living the question.
Wow!
That was fantastic!
That was fantastic!
Yes.
And I also believe that you're a Rays fan.
I am.
Woo! And we're all Rays fan, and they made the playoffs. First playoff game, so good luck, Rays.
All right.
Thank you, Coach Herman, for being a fabulous guest.
Yes.
And have a great weekend.
Bye.
Thanks, Dos Amigos. You brighten up our week just as much as birthdays. Let's see who is celebrating a birthday. There are no birthdays today, But over the weekend, happy birthday to Ryan L. in Mrs. Wood's class and Michael S. in Mrs. Bird's class. And two special teacher birthday shout-outs to Mr. Smith and Miss Ebel. Happy birthday!
Patriots, it has been another great week of learning. Let's take a look back at some of the fun things that happened around school this week. Lunch. For lunch, we are having PB&J to-go box, French market combo, cheese pizza, or pepperoni pizza. Vegetable and fruit choices are carotenis, green beans, fresh fruit, grapes, or juice. And don't forget to choose your milk and utensils.
Today is the last day of Celebrate Freedom Week. We hope you have learned a lot about the Declaration of Independence and how important it is to our country. Let's recite a part of the Declaration of Independence one more time.
Here are some more patriots to lead you in reciting the Declaration of Independence.
We hold these truths to be self-evident.
That all men are created equal.
That they are endowed by their Creator.
With certain unalienable rights.
That among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
To secure these rights,
governments are instituted among men.
Deriving their just powers
from the consent of the governed.
Well, I think that wraps up our news show for today, Patriots. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, and since it's Friday, remain standing for our school song.
Then be seated for a moment of silence.
Have a fantabulous Friday and excellent weekend, Patriots.
And remember, we are living the questions
by feeding our passions
and exploring our wonders. Bye. Bye.